over the earth. So I have sworn that I will not be wroth.
Hey, brother, you got to sing it for a Bible verse?
Come on, brother.
You got to sing it for one Bible verse. I'll sing it for one Bible verse.
One verse.
Is that what? Speak the word to you. All right, but I got you. I'm going to speak the word to you.
All right. No.
You need Job 30 and 30.
No. You the man, bro.
Here we go, my boy.
Hey, relax, bro. Hey, relax. Although I say this, though, right? God put Jacob to a whole lot of stuff. And so everything he had and he felt, then he changed. And then God took away from him, took his health, and gave it back to him because he kept the faith. And that's it.
All right, brother. Yeah. We're going to pray for you, brother. That's it. That's all we can do. All we can do is pray for that man. Right? All we can do is pray for our people, man. We can just go out there and pray for him, man.
That's it.
You know, Rudolph.
So have I sworn that I will not be wroth with thee, nor rebuke thee. For the mountains shall depart, and the hills.
Sister, you ever sing it for a Bible verse?
Come on, Jerry.
Hey,
sister.
She's done. Yeah, she's done. She's studying botany at NC State. She's tennis.
Right?
Every week.
It's spirits out here, man.
Yeah, God.
It's spirits out here.
Yeah, look at it.
Come on, brother.
You got to
say it for a Bible verse? What Bible verse? What's your name, brother? All right, give me Job 30 and 30. Give me Job 30 and 30.
Come, this is the book of Job, chapter 30 and verse 30. My skin is black.
The Lord said it.
My skin is black.
Who the people in the Bible?
My skin is black.
Did you know that was in the Bible? You didn't know that was in the Bible. So guess what? We can show you 144 million other things that you didn't know was in the Bible. This Bible is about you and your history. This is your book that was stolen from your great-great-grandfather. Shouldn't you want to take your book back, or do you want to leave it in the hands of so-called white people? Do you want to take your book back, or do you want to leave it in the hands of the whites?
Come on, brother. Take it back, brother.
Wake him up.
Get off the phone and take your Bible back.
Wake him up.
Take it back, brother.
Wake him up.
Job,
Mark 1 and 15. Give me Mark 1 and 15. Give me Mark 1 and 15. Brother, come here and clear this verse. Hear one verse. Hear one more verse. Hear one more verse, brother. All right, come in. Read that. Matter of fact, come in. Come in. Read that. Mark 1 and 15.
The book of Mark, chapter 1, verse 15. And saying, the time is fulfilled, and the kingdom of God is at hand. Repent ye and believe the gospel.
Well, you got to repent and believe the gospel. If you don't, God's going to kill you.
That's right.
Straight like that.
That's it.
Straight like that.
That's it.
If I start yanking our people up, man, come and hear the word of the Lord, man. You know? Got to come hear the word of the Lord, man. Right? That's it, man. Y'all got to sing for one Bible verse? Hold on. This is not an Instagram rule. You have a second for one Bible verse, sister? You have 1 second to hear one Bible verse from God. All right, you got a second to hear one Bible verse. All right, give me Job 30 and 30. Job 30 and 30. Yeah, Job 30 and 30. What's your name, sister?
Job.
Sister Ronnie? What's your name, sister? All right, Sister Jessica. All
right, read that. This is the book of Job, chapter 30, verse 30. My skin is black. My skin is black. My skin is black.
Hold on. Look at it.
Who knew that? It's in the Bible. Look at it. Pull it up on your phone.
See that?
It's the Bible, sister. Pull it up on your phone.
We are the people of the Bible.
All right, read it again. Look at you. We want to lie to you about God's word. Yeah. I'm just saying, the only person that's going to lie to you about God's word is the so-called white man. He's not going to tell you the truth about the Bible, but we're going to tell you the truth. That's right. So listen, sister. All right, read it again. This is the book of Job, chapter 30, verse 30. My skin is black upon me, and my bones are burn with heat.
What happened when the heat beaming on you? Yeah, and what? And you get a little what? Darker, right? Yeah. So the Bible is about so-called black people. Yeah, of course. But he has a race. What's the name of his race?
Egyptian?
Nope. You said what? Now that's not in the Bible. That's not in the Bible. Nope. That's not in the Bible. It don't start with an E. Give me Isaiah 44:1. Let's find out what it starts with. Isaiah 44:1. Well, this is for edification. We want our people to get saved by God, to not get killed by God. All right?
It's the book of Isaiah, chapter 44, verse 1. Yet, now hear, O Jacob, my servant, and Israel, whom I have chosen.
You hear that? So the name of God's chosen race of people is what? The Israelites. Sister, focus. The Israelites. Sister, focus. Right? Now, these are the Israelites. These are the 12 tribes of the children of Israel.
That's right.
Only an elect amount of these people are going to get saved by God during World War III.
Right.
If you don't want to listen to us, if you don't want to read your Bible, you're not going to make it. So we had to scream at you so that you can listen, so that you don't get hit with a missile. So, the name of the chosen people is called the Israelites. How did our race of people get to America, transportation-wise? Ships, right? Now check this out. Give me the book of Judges, chapter 2, verse 14. Right? Right? Judges 2 and 14.
That's right.
That's it
for joy and sex black.
Right? Now, you said, Sister Ronnie, you said we got here by what part of transportation?
Slave
ships. Right? Now,
oh, hell no.
I want you to listen to this verse. Get into Judges chapter 2 and verse 14. Right? Hit me up, brother. Right? Jake, man. Right? Judges chapter 2 and verse 14. Yeah, he got it.
God, the book of Judges. Chapter 2 and verse number 14. And it reads, in the anger of the Lord.
In the anger of the Lord. Can God get angry? All right, the anger of the Lord
was hot.
Was hot. God was hot at what people?
Against Israel.
Against the Israelites, so-called black, Hispanic, and Native Americans. Read.
And he delivered them into the hands of the spoiler.
Gave them to another race of people. Read.
That spoiled them.
Spoiled means to be robbed. Were we robbed? Yeah, we was robbed from our name. You said African American. That's not in the Bible. That's the name of two continents. Black is just a color. We have a God-given name. Right? We know that spoiled them.
And he sold them.
What did God do?
And he sold them.
What's in the Bible?
And he sold them.
God said in the Bible that everybody claims that they read that he sold Negroes. Why didn't your pastor tell you that? Why didn't they teach you that in school? Why didn't your history class talk about this?
That's right.
Because they don't want you to know that you're an Israelite.
That's right.
You knew that we were sold?
Yes.
Okay.
You read all through the Bible.
Revelation. All right, give me Deuteronomy 22:14.
Hold on, sister.
Bring your time back up here, sister. You ain't gonna leave, man. Give me Deuteronomy 22. No, don't cast the first stone. Read all through the Bible. What the hell is this, man? Oh, that's madness, man. Y'all sisters got a second for a Bible verse? No Bible verse, sisters.
Come on, man.
Damn, freaks in Babylon, man. All right? Yeah, that haughtiness I sport. Strength forth next, man. Put your hand down.
Madness.
Yeah, this is madness, man. This place is absolutely off. Give me the book of Philippians chapter 4 and verse 15. Yeah, it's a lot of people celebrating birthdays and anniversaries and
celebration spirit, man. Right? Philippians chapter, what I call?
4:15.
Come on. It's the book of Philippians, chapter 4, verse 15. Now you Philippians, know also that the beginning of the gospel when that departed from...
Keep going.
I can't read on that though.
4:15. Which one?
Now you Philippians know also that in the beginning of the gospel, when I departed from Macedonia, no church communicated with me as concerning giving and receiving, but ye only.
1 Thessalonians 4:17. I said Philippians. Read 1 Thessalonians 4 and start at verse 15. Come, Salah. All right, we'll get a few more and close out. Kyle, you got it? Kyle, bring it up.
This is the book of 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 18. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, right, that we which are alive and remain on...
Y'all believe, you believe in God, brother? You have one second for one Bible verse? One Bible verse. You gotta go with it. One Bible verse, right? Come on, yeah, brother. One Bible verse. All right, give me Job 30 and 30. Job chapter 30:30. You say you don't know it? Okay, well, check this out.
It's the book of Job chapter 30:30. My skin is black.
My what?
My skin is black.
Did you know that was in the Bible? You definitely didn't know that was in the Bible. So imagine what else we can show you in the Bible that you didn't know. Like your race of people. What did God call your race in the Bible? Well, that's just giving a color or a description of who you are. But it's not letting you know what your nationality is. Children of Israel, where did you hear that from? From us? Well, give me the book of Judges 2:14. You said, we're the Israelites. Let's find out if you're an Israelite. Like Judges 2:14. You said what? Well, I'm telling my brothers to get it, right?
Chapter 2:14. And the anger of the Lord was hot against Israel.
Do you think God is pleased or upset with so-called black people, Hispanic and Native Americans, right now? You said what? I said no. So our people getting gunned down in the streets, being in the projects, first in diabetes, first in heart failure, first in crack cocaine, all make things negative. You don't think that's a judgment from God?
I feel like that's a judgment
between
ourselves.
Between ourselves.
God itself,
but
let's say between the human races and
ourselves. Do you think it's impossible that God sent us to slavery?
Yes, we do.
I don't think it's
impossible.
Did God do it?
No.
Alright, give me Judges 2:14.
This is the book of Judges, chapter 2:14. And the anger of the Lord.
Alright, brother, listen, right?
And the anger of the Lord was hot against Israel.
All humanity.
Against Israel.
The Israelites. God was hot at the Israelites. We are.
And he delivered them into the hands of spoilers.
God delivered them to another race of people. He delivered them into the hands of spoilers.
That spoiled them. And he sold them.
What did God do?
And he sold them.
What did God do?
And he sold them.
What race of people was sold? Yeah, who sold? Huh? Yeah, God. Why did God do that to us? That's right. Give me the book of Deuteronomy 28:15. All right, give me Deuteronomy chapter 28:15. All right, give me Deuteronomy 29:1 first.
It's the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 29:1.
No.
These are the words of the covenant.
Of the what?
Of the covenant.
This book is a covenant. God made a covenant with someone. A covenant is like a contract, right? When you sign contracts and deals,
there's not signatures for everybody. It's between you and that person that you made a deal with. God made a covenant or a contract, which the Lord commanded Moses,
right, Moses
to make with the children of Israel.
So
the contract between the Israelites, God, through his messenger Moses. Does that make sense? Right? Now check this out. Deuteronomy 28:15.
It's the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 15. But it shall come to pass, if thou will not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
If you don't listen to the things that this contract says you must do, read, to observe, to do all his commandments.
That's what the contract is a part of, the commandments. If you keep them, you'll be blessed. If you don't hearken,
and his statutes, which I command thee this day.
Don't listen, what's going to happen to the Israelites?
That all these curses,
all these blessings,
all these curses,
all these good things,
all these curses shall come upon thee.
Are we under blessings or curses right now as a race of people?
I'm going to say both.
Read Deuteronomy 28:54.
It's the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 54.
Now, if this fits your race of people, you'll be an Israelite. And you will be under the curses that God said he will put on the Israelites. Now, if this doesn't apply to you, then you wouldn't be under the curses. Right? So check this out.
Verse 54. So that the man that is tender among you and very delicate.
The man that's tender and delicate. His own race of people. Cordial, kind, nice. Right? So his own race of people.
His eye shall be evil towards his brother.
Now you got an evil spirit towards your own race. What does that sound like? What race of people has an evil spirit toward their own race?
Oh my God.
You said what? Yeah, because, you know, Bloods and Crips, G's, Vice Lords, Billy Mason, right? Gangsta Crips. I can look, I can name them all. Right? Evil eye toward their own people. You got light skin against dark skin. You got blacks against the Hispanics. Same people. Read.
And toward the wife of his bosom.
Evil eye toward his wife. Right? What does that sound like? That sounds like a Tyler Perry movie. Right? Read on.
And toward the remnant of his children, which he shall leave.
Who's gonna stay?
Huxtable
family.
Which he shall leave.
Who's known for having a single parent household? Yeah. Is that obsolete with us today, or is that still in effect? So guess what? If that happens to you, your race of people, then you would be an Israelite.
That's right.
And we break the curses by finding out who you are and living who you are. Give me Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 68.
This is the book of Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 68.
God did this to the Israelites because they're the best people on the earth. And by being the best, you have to act the best. You have to conduct yourself in the manner in which you're supposed to go. Right, read.
And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again.
God said what?
And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again.
Another curse for breaking his commandments, like don't, no killing your own people, no stealing, don't have sex with your brother's wife. Don't do those things. If you begin to do that, God said he will bring you where again?
Into Egypt again.
Into Egypt again. You got a dollar in your pocket? All right, I want you to pull that dollar out, and I want you to look at that dollar. Right? Because God said, if you break the commandments, is it 10? He said that he's going to bring you into Egypt again. Right? You got one? What's on that dollar? What do you see? You see a pyramid. Right? So, God said he'll bring you to Egypt again. So, what is Egypt? Right? Read that.
Exodus chapter 20, verse 2.
Read it.
I am the Lord thy God, which have brought thee out of the land of Egypt.
Now, before, right, there was a point of time where so-called black people were literally in Egypt. He brought you out of Egypt, out of what?
Out of the house of bondage.
What is Egypt?
Out of the house of bondage.
Bondage is slavery, captivity. Right? God brought the black people out of captivity. But God said if you break the commandments, you gotta go back into Egypt, meaning back into what?
back in the captivity. How do we get to America transportation-wise?
Trade.
But what part of transportation? Yep. But what, like, do we fly on water? Right now, what's the name of the people that we're reading about? Israelites. Read again from the top.
Huh, this is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28 and verse 68. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again.
Slavery again? But how are the Israelites going to get into slavery?
With ship.
With what?
With ship.
With a plane.
With ship.
God's charge.
With ship.
Hellcat.
With ships.
With ships. Guess what this was written at this entire time? In the Bible. But your pastor never told you.
That's right.
Your math teacher never told you.
That's right.
Your history teacher didn't tell you.
That's right.
Your basketball or your football coach didn't tell you.
That's right.
Right? Why? Because you'll find this out in the last days.
Right.
And this is for your generation to know. And for you to get the kingdom. Because you had to serve a punishment in America.
Right?
With ships, you know?
By the way whereof I spake unto thee.
Same way God said you would go to slave or slave ships, that's literally how it happened. The Atlantic slave trade happened.
That's right.
The Silk Road slave trade happened.
That's right.
The Sub-Saharan slave trade happened.
That's
we were sold by the Arab people. Right? And you were sold to Chinese people and you built the Great Wall of China. Right, Reed?
Thou shalt see it no more again.
Right. And guess what? We got good news. This is the last time Negroes are going to be in slavery.
That's right.
This is it. Once you go to slavery and slave ships, guess what? That's it. Your king is about to be on the way. This is when you're going to find out that you're not niggas. That you're not just black. Right? You know?
And there,
when you get off the slave ships,
ye shall be sold. You
shall be freedmen.
You shall be sold.
Yeah, that's why your last name is Johnson, Robinson, Simpson, right? All those things.
Right.
When you get off the slave ships, the Israelites are going to be sold.
That's right.
Right? This happened in Wilmington, North Carolina.
Right.
This happened in Newport News, Virginia.
Right.
This happened in Jamestown, Virginia.
Right.
Then Pennsylvania, then Mississippi, and all these different slave ports. The Bible's a history book. But our people don't read it as a history book. Right, Reed?
And there ye shall be sold unto your enemies.
And God said white people are enemies. It's that simple.
Right.
Straight up and down, they're your enemies. They've never been your friend. Right? Your friends won't hang you on trees.
Right.
Your friends won't feed your children the alligators.
Right?
Your friends won't change the laws and say that you can be a homosexual. Right? And there you shall be sold unto your enemies. Right? That's in the Bible. Right, Reed?
For bond men and bond women, and no man shall buy you.
We still over here in America thinking that we're black.
That's right.
But we're actually the Israelites.
That's right.
The best people on the earth. I mean, who's better than us? Who are the best athletes?
Come on now.
Who the best dancers? Who the best cooks?
Right.
Who has the most inventions?
Ooh.
So-called black people created a car, an airplane, the internet, the computer, all while they were in slavery.
Right.
So imagine what we would do if we are not in slavery. There's a statement of this government that says, we fear a black nation, a black rulership. Because guess what? Every kingdom is going to fall. And before every great kingdom falls, the Lord sends his prophets to tell the people that they're Israelites. Like this brother, you're an Israelite, brother. God chose the people. Right? But we don't know it. So what did God call your nationality?
What? Israelites.
That's right, an Israelite. Right? An Israelite. And y'all got to come back to God because you're in the last days. Do you have any questions? No questions about the Bible? From Genesis to Revelation, no question. All right, well, the brother going to give you a card. I want you to learn about the history and get a Bible that you can make it in World War III. Because World War III will happen, and there's going to be no more America on the face of the earth.
That's right.
We're going to go somewhere else. All right, I'll pray to the Most High. Y'all are Israelites. All right, God's chosen people. All right, black people are better than white people.
That's right.
It's recorded in the Bible that so-called black people are better than white people. That's in the Bible. Yeah, sister, you gotta leave that white devil, that red demon. You gotta leave him, sister.
right?
He's putting wicked spirits on you, sister. He's putting wicked spirits on you, sister. He don't even love you, sister. Right? He's treating you like a hoochie mama. Right? A damn bad witch, man. What the hell is this? You said what? Yeah. Nah. We don't celebrate birthdays. We keep God's commandments. Yeah, it's black power. You said what? Yahusha. Yeah, Yahusha. You from New York? You from New York? What part? All right, Brooklyn, Brownsville. All right, shout out to Brooklyn, shout out to Brownsville. All right, brother, but guess what? You need to shout out the Most High God, Yahweh.
Who's that?
What do you mean, who is that, brother? That New York spirit, man. Yeah, that New York spirit. Oh, yeah, he's from New York, so so he got, so he gonna do his thing. He gonna do his thing. I forgot. Hey, yo, brother. Come on, brother. Yeah, come on, brother. All right, shout out to Pop Smoke, brother. Yeah. Hey, that New York spirit, man. Hey, shout out to New York, though. The spirit moves in New York, man. Yeah, the spirit moves in New York. Yeah, the spirit moves. Yeah, the spirit is in New York. Right? So the angels are in New York. The angels are in New York. But guess what? New York is going to get overthrown by the Most High God. New York is gonna get, and America's gonna get overthrown by God. And white people are gonna get overthrown by God.
Right? Wake them up.
Now give me Isaiah chapter 25, verse 7. Hey, brother, man, you got a second for a Bible verse? Don't say for a Bible verse. What are you doing out here in Glenwood, brother? You're supposed to be a king on the earth, brother. Right? You're not a gangster either, brother. Yeah, put your pants up, brother. You know? Jake think he a gangster, man. Jake, you're not a gangster, man. The so-called white man is a gangster. The so-called white man is going to have a briefcase, and he's going to be a professional hitman.
Right?
He's going to look like a doctor or something. Right? Jake going to have his pants down, trying to run for the damn feds with his pants down.
Right.
You know, the feds after me. Come on, brother. You know? Madness, man. Death to USA. And death to white people, man. Death to the white man. Oh, man. Pray for curses to the so-called white man, right? Right? Isaiah chapter 25, verse 7. Right? Let me get the book of Matthew chapter 16 and verse 19.
The book of Isaiah chapter 25 and verse 7. And he will destroy in this mountain the face of the covering cast over our people. And the veil that is spread over our nations.
And this is the veil that's spread over our nations, man. Our people don't know what the hell is going on, man. Hey, sister, you're an Israelite, God's chosen people. Yeah, you gotta come back to God, sister. We love you. Right, you gotta let go of that lesbianism. Right, let go of that lesbianism, man. Right, don't be lesbians like the so-called white men or homosexuals. Right, that's what God said. Now, what do you expect? What do you expect? Don't you know God about destroying America? You think we're gonna come out here and tell you lies? Right, she was flabbergasted, man. Like, oh my God. You said I was an agent? Yeah, all these damn agents out here, we don't give a damn, man. Right? You know? You said it's your roommate? Hey, watch out for that Jeffrey Dahmer spirit. Right? I don't want him to eat you, brother. So-called white people are known for eating blacks. So be careful, brother. Right? You know, I would never have a so-called white roommate. You know, he might cut your foot off, man. And start examining his stuff, man. I wonder how the Negro's foot is getting so big, yo. I want to examine it. What the hell is this, man? You know? All right, bring it out, man.
It's the book of Isaiah, chapter 25 and verse 7.
Like, we got a happy spirit on us because we know that we're about to go home, man. You know, and the so-called white man's kingdom is coming to an end.
That's right.
No more steroids for the so-called white man.
Right.
You know? Read that.
God, and he will destroy in this mountain the face of the covering.
Hey, back up. Put your hand down. 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 Are you an Arab, man? Are you an Arab? Ishmael? Are you a madman? And you're a madman. All right, read that. Death to all so-called Arabs.
What? Look at that didgeridoo.
Right? Are you Elamite? You Elab? Where are you from?
That's a wolf.
Right here.
New York, baby. New York, you see.
Yeah, he don't want to serve God. He don't want to serve God. He want to serve Satan.
That's right.
Khan, the book of Isaiah, chapter 25 and verse 7.
Bring it out.
And he would destroy in this mountain the face of the covering cast over all people and the veil that is spread over all nations. He will swallow up death and victory, and the Lord God will wipe away tears from off all faces from off the earth.
For the Lord has spoken it. What this is saying is God is going to save Negroes, Hispanics, and Native Americans and put the other nations in their rightful positions as slaves.
Right?
Khan, verse 9. And it shall be said in that day, lo, this is our God.
This is everybody's God.
This is our God.
This is God.
This is our God.
This is our God. No, this is our God.
This is our God.
No, it's not your God.
There's only one God.
Yeah, but he's not your God.
Right. Our God.
No, you're a bastard.
That's right.
You're a bastard.
That's right.
Yeah, are you Aladdin? Who are you?
Who are you? Nowhere.
You're from nowhere? What's your nationality? What's your nationality? Okay, well give him one of your gas stations then.
That's right.
Give him one of your gas stations.
Right now.
Whoa. How many gas stations do you own?
We are waiting for him, and he will save us. He will save us. This is the Lord. We are waiting for him. We will be glad and rejoice in his salvation.
So much I can have a shot. Right, bring it out.
This is the book of Matthew, chapter 16, verse 19. And I will give unto thee the keys of the kingdom of heaven.
What the Lord said?
And I will give unto thee the keys of the kingdom of heaven.
What the Lord said?
And I will give unto thee the keys of the kingdom of heaven. And whatsoever thou shalt bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. And whatsoever thou shalt loose on earth shall be loose in heaven.
Show my shack outside, man. Let's get the alabaster box. We're gonna close out and we're gonna leave the satanic forces. Right? Alabaster box. And we're gonna face the east.
He put the stick in between them.
Yeah, he got it. The Most High got us.
Watch her with the woman, for she has run the work upon her feet.
for ye have poor our way for you. But me do not have a way. Who is that? She has poured the torment from my body. She did it for my burial. Buried I say to you, whatsoever the gospel shall be preached in the whole world, there shall be also this, that this woman has done to be told in the memorial from her.
Step to America.
Come on, y'all.